my name's Alicia Beecham, and I'm one of the directors at Hope Tank. I actually grew up near here in Neodesha, Kansas, and came back to Independence about 15 years ago. I have a big heart for women's ministry, and I'm a local pastor with the Independence Church of the Nazarene. And we're just really excited to tell you a little bit about Hope Tank today.
Hi, I'm Hannah Reisner, and I'm actually from Chinook. I've lived here in Independence probably about 20 years. Let's see, how I'm 42. Yeah, about 22 years I've been here. Anyways, through many years of trauma and childhood and where the Lord has taken me, I've had a burning passion for women to be restored and brought back to wholeness through Jesus Christ. And Hope Tank here, this building, is part of that vision that the Lord has laid on my heart for many years. Back in 2017, he really started to burn that in me, and he brought along a partner to minister with. And we both have the same heart and the same desire to see women that are broken brought back to restoration and to made whole. I am a district licensed pastor through the Church of the Nazarene, and I actually co-pastor Axis with Jay Reed and Bill Knight. And we actually do a crossroad ministry at the jail here. We go every Monday and we meet with the women in the jail, which we think is a great way to connect. They're at a crossroads in their life as they're in the jail. And if we can meet them there and get them out and come into a place that can restore and bring them back to a place of functionality and society and redemption, that is our hope, because what we see is a lot of women come out and don't have anywhere to go. So this would be a perfect place and a perfect way to connect with them.
So this hotel used to be a drug location filled with hopelessness and despair. What we want to do is take this den of destruction and turn it into a house of healing. And so this particular building will be our area that is accessible by the community. So over here we would have our main office, and behind that there would be a kitchen, along with enough space to do family style meals together, because community and fellowship is a big part of recovery. And the women and children that would be staying here need to be connected to one another, not just while they're in the program, but we want to open this space up to women once they're done as well, so that they can stay connected. So all of these are single bedrooms right now, but we would come in and remove walls to create larger classrooms with dividers, so that we could have multi-purpose rooms that would be used for a sanctuary, classrooms, a media room for kids that need internet access to do homework. The building comes with plenty of broken glass to do mosaics with, and we also want to use these multi-purpose rooms to bring in outside people with really specific skill sets in health, wellness, parenting, and just people that can mentor the women here. And so this will be a great spot for the community to be able to come in and see what we're doing and help us by volunteering to teach classes every day.
So a key component to the Hope Tank Ministry would be that we would have places within this first area that people could come and volunteer. And the first one would be like a food pantry. We would like to have someone come in and help manage that, donate items, you know, be in charge of like what we need and so forth. And we actually would like to have classes that we could teach these women how to cook, because that's part of the process of healing as well, is to get them to a place where they can be mothers, that they can cook. And then we would move on and we would have like a laundry area. We want to teach them how to do laundry. You know, how do you do laundry? You don't do your whites with your reds, obviously. That will be part of that, teaching their kids as well of a whole integral part of healing and getting them back on their feet to where they know that they can be functional on their own.
So this area here is currently a road. However, we would want to construct a privacy fence around the whole perimeter of the property. That way we can offer safety, and we also can contain the area. We won't allow cars to come back here, because safety of the children here and the women here is our number one priority. And just like Paul wrote to the Philippians about how their coming to Christ was really his glory and his joy. And these women are our crowns. And so we come to our first building. So welcome to Glory. This is where women and their children will come to live during the duration of their program, which is going to be roughly 6 to 7 months of classes and programs and therapy and recovery. So in this building, what we will do is we will get rid of all of the walls, and it will become a dormitory style building for the single ladies, and they will have private rooms with shared facilities like bathrooms and showers. And then at the end of the building, we will have separate double rooms to accommodate women that are here with their children. They will also have use of shared shower and bathroom facilities. And we just want to be able to give the singles the quiet time that they need. And at the same time, we want to be sure that we're giving the mothers community with each other so that they can learn from each other and help each other out along the way.
So this area here is where we have a vision of having a playground for the children. Since this building here, we will have women and children. We would like them to have a safe place where they can play and where they can just be kids. And then this building over here, so welcome to Joy. This building here would be our long-term living quarters for the women as they graduate the Hope Tank program. What we see for women when they come out of jail from other programs is that they go through a program and maybe they graduate, but then once they're done, they fall back into the old patterns because they lose community with those around them that are just leaning them in towards Christ versus being pulled away by their old connections. So we want this place to be a place of community, not just for those that are in the program, but for those that maybe have graduated and come out and can live here. These will be set up as a dormitory style. Will there be individual living quarters where they will have private bathrooms? Even maybe they'll have like mini fridges and things like that where they can be a little more functional on their own, but yet they can still be part of a community, and then they will give back to that community with volunteering, and maybe even to the point where if they get jobs, then we will have a budget set up for them so that they can learn how to budget their money, and so that they can save and that they can give back, and then at some point that they would be able to find their own place and be on their own, but that they would always still have this family connection, because that's so important and so key, because see, God is relational and we need each other. And a lot of these women don't have family, or maybe they've burned their bridges, or maybe they just are from far from home, and this is where they've landed, and we can be an extension of that family for them. So that is our hope here for the long-term living facility. So I don't know about you, but I run out of gas a lot. Like, it's probably a running joke in my family, like to the point where I'll pass a gas station and they'll be like, "Mom, you need to get gas," and I'll be like, "I'm okay." Literally, the last time I did this, I pulled into the gas station and didn't even make it to the pump. And yeah, I had to go into the convenience store and buy a gas tank to put gas in my car because my pride wouldn't allow me to come over and to put gas in the tank. So what do people do when their tanks are running low? Because, you know, we live in a world where there's a lot of people that have no hope left. So just like when we're driving our car and we're running on E, we have got to go to the gas station and we have got to fill up our tank. Hope Tank is going to be a place where people can come that are running low, they've run out of hope, and that they can be filled up with the hope of Jesus Christ, and that we can love them and we can encourage them and we can bring them to the place of full redemption, because that's the God that we serve. He's a redeemer and he takes all things and he creates a new person, and that's what we want for each and every one of these ladies, because we ourselves have been redeemed. And when he says, "You go back and you tell your brothers and sisters," and that is exactly what we want to do, is we want to go back and tell our sisters, "Hey, there is hope and there is something different you, and God has a plan for your life."
Amen. We just want to take a spot and come in and be hope dealers where the dope dealers used to prosper. You are my